I shall not want. This overflow in abundance, when it comes, you will not want. Did you see that? You are not in need of anything. That is called overflow, because ni nwere ya rie nne. But it happens to the persons whom the Lord is their shepherd. And the Lord is their Lord and their only personal Savior. He said, the Lord is my shepherd. So if he's not your shepherd and you are not his sheep, and he is not the only Lord of your life, because there are so many people who have different lords. And some are in church. There are also so many people who go to church and some who come to church. They don't want to give their lives to Jesus. What they have chosen to do is to withhold their lives. Nke ha nyere nye ha nakwara. Are we still here? The one you gave, you have collected it back. And so for such persons, that verse is not for you. He said, the Lord is my shepherd. He's the one that guides me. That's what a shepherd does. He's the one that directs my path. He's the one I follow. So if you are not following Jesus, that verse doesn't cover your interests. And so I encourage you tonight to follow him so that your interests will be covered. Amen. Amen, church. The Lord help us. Now, look at verse 2. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. That is what the shepherd, the one who is your one and only Savior, and the one whom is the only person you know, that is what he does for you. Am I saying this? You must make him your shepherd. You must make him your Lord. Because there are several contentions over your life. And these contentions is between the devil and God. It is between the temple of God and the temple of Balaam, idol. It is between worldliness and godliness. And in all these two, you must choose one. Please tap your neighbor and tell your neighbor you must choose one. The one you choose will govern your life. The one you choose will govern your principles and your values. So you must make a choice. And the Bible says you cannot serve two masters at a time. It's not possible. So your loyalty must be to one. And I encourage people wherever I go, don't be a church goer. Don't be a seat warmer. Because when the chips are down, you will be on a very dangerous tight corner. So it is better to take a decision and take the decision properly. Now, as we proceed, the Bible says, in verse 4, go to verse 4. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadows of death, I will fear no evil. Jehovah Nadendo. Jehovah Nadendo.
Asina meje ije nandaguru kwamu Jehovah.
Now, can I let you know that the value of the shadows of death, they have like sizes. They come in sizes. It could be a sickness that is chronic, and they will tell you nobody has ever survived this sickness. And therefore, fear. We want to take you to the grave before the death arrives. That is a size of the value of the shadow of death. But what does the Bible say? It says, even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will do what? So, get an artistic old job.